competition about to begin at the Portimão World Challenge Cup. The finalists in the five hoops competition, top performers in qualification, the Italians, so they will go right at the end of this final. We'll start with the second best in qualifying, Spain. In qualification for Italy, 34.85. Azerbaijan on 32.2 in third place, leading something of a peloton with a gap of almost 2 marks between third and second. You just never know, though, with a group final. Lots of variables. Delegation playing their part. It gives us perhaps a little flavour of what we're going to enjoy at the World Championships in Valencia in August. Beautiful time of the year in a beautiful part of the world. In a nation that adores its rhythmic gymnastics. And they adore watching Evita Griskaynis, considering how well she's performed for the United States of America. And they will get to see their group as well, the American fans in action later on today. They'll be in the mixed apparatus final. Spain will begin this five hoops final. Five gymnasts, Ana Arnau, Inés Burgua, Mireia Martínez, Patricia Pérez, and Salma Salaun. Valeria Marquez had to withdraw from the competition a short while ago. So just the five gymnasts from Spain have come to this event, so all five will perform at both pieces. They were the all-around champions over the last couple of days. Let's enjoy this five hoop performance from Spain. 34 in qualification. Thank you. It really is a lovely routine, that. Some moments of beautiful construction. The whole thing hangs together very nicely. And they are a group who have developed enormously since their formation. Wonderful that they took 3 bronze medals at the World Championships. They qualified for the Olympiad. After they made such a spirited effort to get to the Olympic Games in Tokyo. But now they're in a very good spell in their careers. Becoming commonplace to see these gymnasts beaming as they walk off the competition floor, and they are hugely popular too from a great rhythmic gymnastics nation. Naturally, they're eyeing their home World Championships. It's that always entrancing beginning, just looks lovely. They had a few adjustments that were necessary. Some of the catches were not fully in control. There was one quite close to the beginning that almost went out of bounds, but nice synchronization in the attitude devant spins. That's such a nice moment of partnership as well. They use a sense of canon very nicely throughout this routine. It was better than qualification, 34.45 for Spain. They gain almost half a mark from the preliminary round. Now to Mexico. Sofia Flores, Julian Gutierrez, Kimberly Salazar, Adrián Tejeda and Karen Villanueva. Dalia Alcocer had to withdraw recently, so Karen Villanueva has come in. Julia Gutierrez is a newer member of the group. But many of these gymnasts won the all-around silver medal at the Pan American Championships last year. Sixth best in qualification, 31.3.
Thank you. midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood. To paradise is your neighborhood. The troops never shall be found. Without the soul, your king of town.
They really do perform that well. At the heart of it, it helps that they are all really good dancers. They deliver the choreography with a sense of style. It's a nice cohesive routine. It responds to the changes in music. They've got some clever moments of partnership throughout. Group from Mexico with a score of 31.3 in qualification. Mexico, owners of just two medals in Rhythmic Gymnastics World Cup competition. One of them a gold. Yes, it certainly was a calm performance. They did do very well. Great opening. They established that opening position very well. Adds a little theatricality to it, setting up and then striding across the diagonal. The audience is always intrigued. And they go back to a very similar position towards the end as well, which gives the whole thing a sense of harmony. .8 the score for Mexico. Not quite as strong across the board. Just little drops in all of their three components. Difficulty, execution, artistry. To an overall drop of 0.5. Azerbaijan. I represent them. Gulu Agarajadeh, Laman Alimuradova, Kamila Alieva, Zeynep Pomatova and Yelizaveta Luzan. They were the all-around bronze medalists and the third best in the qualification phase for this final. They won their first medals of the season in Baku, but they're yet to win anything in the single apparatus. They've had some success this season, the Azerbaijan group, as they eye their home European Championships in just over a week's time. It's a difficult routine, and it always scores very highly from a difficulty standpoint. It tends not to score as high artistically as a lot of the other routines. It was the lowest scoring routine artistically of any of the qualifiers. But it does have some nice homages to traditional Azerbaijani folk music, particularly Mughan. Just a sense that there's more to come from it as a display. It's got some nice features like the encouragement for the audience to join in with the clapping. A couple of nice bits of choreography that really link in with that very distinctive Azerbaijani folk music, which is a beautiful European folk music tradition. Sounds like no other folk music at all in Europe, the Azerbaijani folk music, that real meeting point of the East and the West. It's got a wonderful sound to it. Decent amplitude on a lot of the releases of the apparatus. Lovely rebound pass there. This is a nice sequence. A couple of very clever passes as well that almost too quick to see initially. But that little scoot back just behind the music might be moderately costly. But it is still a very good score, 32.15 for Azerbaijan. Almost the same as qualification, just 500ths lower. So a good case made by Azerbaijan to get onto the podium once again. We have five to go. If you're just switching on your TV now, then it is very exciting to see some history-making occasions at this World Challenge Cup competition in Portimão. We've had the first ever Kazakhstan gold medal in a World Challenge Cup event. Aliya Yusupova won a gold medal back in 2003 in a World Cup competition. That's Kazakhstan's only other gold medal before today. Now, meanwhile, Mexico have submitted an inquiry, so we'll have a little delay while that is being scrutinised by the jury. Later today, we'll see a very rare appearance from Switzerland in an individual rhythmic gymnastics World Cup final. Still to come in this final, we've got Germany, Japan, France, Brazil, Italy. And in the next individual final, the club's final, we'll see joining the nations that we've already had so far. We'll have the People's Republic of China, Japan, and as I mentioned before, Switzerland. We still have representation from Brazil to come in the individual events as well, and Brazil will be competing in just a few routines time in this single apparatus competition. Van Arbelishvili joining her Georgian teammates in the crowd. So waiting in the wings, the German group for the conclusion of this inquiry. It can be disruptive part of these events, the inquiry process, because the competition cannot continue until the routine has been looked at a second time. As I'm sure many of you know, the gymnasts are only able to challenge the difficulty score. They can challenge either the apparatus difficulty or the body difficulty or both. And it does cost the Federation money to submit an inquiry, but if they are successful, if the score does increase, then naturally that check is not cashed, because it was their correct decision. The financial penalty, the only cost in an inquiry system in rhythmic gymnastics, the score is not at risk. There are some sports where you can actually gift marks to your opponent or lose marks if you make an unsuccessful challenge. Mexico's challenge was unsuccessful. And the competition will continue any moment now. Germany next to go. We have Anja Kossan, Daniela Krom, Alina Oganessian, Francine Schöning, and Hannah Vesta. The same group that competed at the World Championships, where all of these gymnasts won a team silver medal. They finished just outside of the top 10 at the European Championships in the all-around competition. They have already won 2 silver medals this season, both of them in Tashkent. What can they do here in Portugal? 31.6, the fifth best in qualification. What a shame that Germany had a real loss of one of the hoops needing the replacement apparatus, and consequently so much of the routine had to be sacrificed. They were just frozen there waiting to be able to resume it. Otherwise, it was a perfectly secure-looking performance. Back the replacement hoop goes. Such a difficult moment for any group of gymnasts when they have to get the alternative apparatus and make a split-second decision. It's got a nice opening to it. Growing sense of style to this group, the more they compete together. Of partnership. And it was there, just the miscatch, prompting a very quick adjustment. Quite a way down from qualification, 29.05. Fourth position and a drop of about 2.5 marks from the preliminary round. To Japan. Representing them, Imaoka Rina, Inaki Rinako, Nishimoto Megumi, Suzuki Ayuka and Takanaka Nanami, the fourth best in qualification. Three of these gymnasts were in the top 10 at the World Championships in the all-around competition. This is a very impressive routine. It's a real crowd pleaser, that. And justifiably, no sense of subtlety to the orchestration. It's a bumptious bolero, but they do make it work. They've got that skill, these wonderful gymnasts from Japan, of carrying big orchestration. It's a gamble when you take a piece of music as iconic as a bolero. It's even more of a gamble when you layer it and it becomes so almost ostentatious. But one gets the feeling with these gymnasts that you're in safe hands musically. From a nation with a magnificent group rhythmic gymnastics tradition. At the heart of this, some really good passes. Three hoops caught really nicely in a cannon early on in the performance. Some quite big amplitude in the throws too. I mean, they really are getting the hoops up into the rafters of the building. And that's so important, not to have tentative releases. A lot of the trajectory judgment was very good. Not fully together in the front attitude pirouettes, but they were individually well performed. Maybe that it just lacked some of the sharpness of qualification, but not by a million miles, if at all. 30.6, so it is indeed 0.8 down from qualification. The execution has come off by about a full mark. There's little adjustments here and there proving costly for Japan. They are still in possession of a good routine there. Representing France. This group that was 11th at the World Championships last year. 8th best in qualification with a score of 30.45. And they won 3 bronze medals at the Sofia World Cup. tricky old routine that for France. Representing them, Eleanor Cabaret, Emma Dalen, Manel Inao, Justine Levy, and Lozea Villarino. Just had a few scrambles to get control of the apparatus. It is a group that's had a few changes of late, and naturally that has an enormous impact on the sense of partnership and the sense of timing in these routines. But they've been a very positive force in World Cup competition over the last couple of seasons, going right the way back to Athens last year when they surprisingly and impressively won the all-around title. Maybe a bit of a struggle to get onto the podium on this occasion, but certainly we look forward to seeing them at the European Championships in just over a week's time. Just had a little clatter of a catch right at the start, two hoops almost jostling together, but other elements were very together. Nice dynamic balance work. That was pretty as a picture in terms of the synchronization. Quite big adjustments, missing the catch on that occasion, the centre of the space, the trajectory just was never quite on. I'm sure you could see at the end there a real lunge to get the hoop. I was going to say, one imagines it will be quite a bit lower than qualifying, and it is 27.75, drop of 2.7. It's unfortunate for France. Well, they'll get a good reception, the Brazilian gymnasts. Lots of their fans here to support them. They were the seventh best in qualification. Score 30.55. Reigning Pan American champions in single apparatus gymnastics. is just bags of entertainment. What a performance from Brazil, and what a reaction from their fans and from their gymnasts too. I think they are pretty delighted with that display. They just bring a real energy to every competition. The score in qualification for Brazil was 30.55, the seventh best. And that was the performance of Maria Eduarda Aracaki, Vitória Borges, Giovanna Oliveira, Sofia Pereira and Nicole Pircio. They might do rather well. They've got a lovely sense of performance that underpins the whole thing. Good choreography. It is quite a difficult routine, though. Just a question of where they're going to end up. It looked transformed from the preliminary round. It was good then, but it just looked a million miles from it. .34.45 leads the way. That's Spain. Can they get close to that? Oh, they've gone into the lead! 34.6! We have just seen a moment of history. Brazil has just won at least a silver medal, and that's their best ever finish in the FIG Rhythmic Gymnastics World Cup Series. A nation that has won four bronze medals is about to win at least a silver with only one group to go. They've done it! They've made history! Italy, the last to go. A group that contains gymnasts who have stood on an Olympic podium. Martina Centofanti, Agnese Duranti, Alessia Marelli, Daniela Mogurian and Laura Paris. The top performers in qualification with 34.85. The Brazilians on 34.6. This could be a very close finish. It is an unbelievably complicated piece of rhythmic gymnastics that. There is intricacy abounding, and it's made for a fascinating conclusion to the final. Brazil 34.6, Italy with a mark of 34.85 in qualification. It could be very tight. Now, in terms of difficulty, the Italians are likely to take this, but was the control fully there? It certainly was compellingly performed, albeit with a couple of moments where you just felt they were racing to get the apparatus under control. European Championships on the horizon for the Italians. Brazilians will be eyeing more success at the Pan American Championships. Lovely cleanliness there. That's a wonderful moment. The precision of those catches. The gymnast just waiting for the apparatus to land. It has to be judged so perfectly, because any adjustment will be so noticeable. Just got there at the end as well. It was a little awkward. Now, what does it mean from a score point of view? Will they surpass Brazil? Weight is on for the Italians and for the Brazilians, who've already achieved their best ever result. So this final score to come in, Brazil currently leads 34.6. Italy, who were better than them in qualification, but who perhaps weren't quite as clean as in the preliminary round, wait for their score. Italy with a score of 33.8, and that means a moment that has never happened in the Rhythmic Gymnastics World Cup Series. Brazil takes a gold medal. The Seleção Brasileira on top of the podium in Portimão. It's the bronze to Italy, the silver to Spain, and the gold medal for the first time ever in an FIG Rhythmic Gymnastics World Cup event to Brazil. We promised you history, and now you've had a little more of it. Well, how about that for a moment for the ages? An event